So someone just sent me this. Who won the USPS contract? And it says Workhorse, but unfortunately, it's just a West Coast-based investment banking firm that predicts that they'll win the $8.1 billion contract. So we didn't exactly get the USPS contract, but there is some news that's coming out tomorrow, possibly, that could be very important for the stock and for the company, either us getting the contract or us not getting the contract. And either way, I think it will send the stock up or down pretty drastically. Now, I'm not saying that it's definitely going to happen, but I would be very cautious going forward. And I think it's something that you need to know, in addition to some information on a possible bill that could cause the USPS to have to electrify their fleet by 75% and either make it electric or zero emission. So that's something that I want to hit on towards the end that's going to be really important for the future. And it kind of talks about how Biden and the Democrats feel about Workhorse. So if you guys like this, please leave a thumbs up. I appreciate it. Please check out the link down below to Webull if you want some free stocks. Definitely check that out because you can get three free stocks if you deposit $100. So Workhorse is up about 7.5% today. The whole EV market is up after XPeng released some earnings. They 4x their revenue year over year. So I have a video on that. But Workhorse is up 7.5%. And this is in front of some possible news that's going to come out tomorrow. So the Board of Governors is set to meet for the USPS tomorrow. Now, a lot of people are expecting something to come out of this. So if you look here, it's going to be on November 13 at 9 a.m. And I'll just walk you through what they're going to discuss. They're going to discuss the approval of minutes, committee reports, financial matters, including their 10-K and financial statements, annual report to Congress, fiscal year 2021 integrated financial plan and borrowing resolution, congressional reimbursement requests for fiscal year of 2022, quarterly service performance bylaws, approval of tentative agenda for February meetings, board leadership, and adjournment. Now, does any of that include the next generation EVs? No. So the next generation vehicles that Workhorse is vying for, this $8.1 billion contract, is not included in here. And I think a lot of people are buying into the stock thinking that this might be announced tomorrow. And I'm not going to say it is or it isn't, but it's not on the list of things that they're talking about. And I personally don't think that they will announce it. Now, if they do, that's great. I am still holding on to my shares. I have not sold out of any of my stock so far. So I am still holding strong. I did a video just yesterday on my price prediction, and I think it's going to go up from here, especially towards the end of the year when a lot of people think that we're going to get the USPS contract. I think that there is going to be an upward movement, but the thing is, I think a lot of people are thinking that this is going to be the announcement in the USPS Board of Governors meeting. Now, I am cautious about this just for the fact that I don't think this is going to happen. And we have seen a little bit of a run-up over the last 5 days. We went from under $17 to about 21% up or 22% up, all the way up to 2150 or 2050. So I would be cautious. Now, I did, like I said, I gave my price prediction and what I think we could hit if we get 100% of the USPS contract. I think we could hit 150. Now, I don't think this is very likely. I just covered this yesterday. I think more likely we would see 25 to 50%. But when you just consider all the bullish things that have come out on Workhorse recently, first of all, Biden wants to push for these EVs in the USPS. So Biden is very pro-USPS. He said that he wants to help them. He's publicly condemned Trump's handling of postal issues, saying his opponent attacked the USPS and flirted with privatizing the mailing industry. So he is going to help them, at least that's what he said in the past. And if you remember, the House Democrats passed this infrastructure bill to give the USPS $25 billion for e-vehicles and facility updates. They would include this $6 billion for money that would go towards buying a delivery vehicle fleet. This would require them to replace their fleet of Grumman long-life vehicles with at least 75% electric or zero-emission vehicles. Now, just to be completely clear, this has not gone through yet. However, it is part of a very large bill. The Moving Forward Act is actually $1.5 trillion. Only part of it is on the USPS. It goes through everything from roads and how we drive to rural communities getting broadband internet, from improving ports and train networks, investing in schools and childcare. This is really a huge bill, and I don't think it's going to be passed anytime soon because, honestly, we have much more pressing issues today in the U.S. We still have not gotten any form of stimulus, and this is because of the lame duck session right now, the fact that we haven't been able to actually go through with it. Trump doesn't really want to push it through. If Biden is going to come up, he doesn't want to agree to a too large a bill. So this is a very expensive bill, the $1.5 trillion bill, but it is something that kind of gives us an idea for what we're pushing for, what the president and what the Democrats are pushing for. And this would include the cash for clunkers. This would include extra EV tax credits. This would also include some USPS charging stations. So they're talking about having every USPS office having a charging station by 2026. Now, again, this is not something that's happening right now, but this is something that's out there. This is something that could happen a few years from now. So I think it is very important to take a look at and something that's very important to consider while we're moving forward. It is something that shows that the House Democrats and Biden really want to electrify the USPS fleet. Now, of course, they aren't the ones that control who gets this contract, but it does show their support in the future for this. And then just going through every video that I've done before, I think there's so much going for Workhorse right now. They're really the only EV option left in the race. I do think that they're going to get a significant portion of this contract. But if you are just buying this short term, thinking you're going to flip a quick profit, it is a very high risk, high reward stock. And you could see a major dip in the next few days. So I just want to come with this video before this date happened, just so you knew tomorrow, if I'm not able to make a video for this, or for some reason, you know, you're questioning if the stock is down significantly or if it's up significantly, something probably came out in that meeting for the USPS that was probably unexpected. So I wanted to let you know. Also, I just wanted to show you the Moving Forward bill and kind of talk to you about how the president feels about Workhorse. So he hasn't directly talked about Workhorse, but I think you can definitely tell which way Democrats are leaning towards. So thank you guys so much for watching this. I really appreciate it. Thank you for hitting the like button. Thank you for checking out Webull. And then I did a video on XPeng earlier today. You should definitely check it out. It'll be right here on the end screen, but it's on them growing their revenues 4x over last year. So definitely check that out, and I'll see you in this video.